KiwiSaver, most of us have it, but how much do we actually know about where our money is being invested and what kind of fees we're paying? Sometimes that stuff can seem a bit boring. But a new online tool has revealed the fees some KiwiSaver funds are charging are actually gobbling up most of the returns. The FMA's KiwiSaver tracking tool shows some KiwiSaver funds took more than a dollar in fees for every $4 they returned. And one fund ate into the capital of its investors because its fees came on top of negative returns. You actually lost money. Massey University banking expert Claire Matthews is with us on this morning. Tēnā koe, Claire. Good morning.
Good morning, Jack.
Do Kiwis pay enough attention to the fees they're paying in their KiwiSaver funds?
I don't think they have historically, but I think there's a growing interest in fees, partly because there's a lot of attention being paid to it by various people, so it's raising consciousness around that issue.
Is that just because we've been somewhat financially illiterate in the past or just can't really be bothered in checking in?
It's probably a little bit of both, to be honest. Certainly we know that Kiwis are not as financially literate as we would like them to be, and so that's part of the problem. But there is a bit of an apathy, and that's reflected in the fact that a lot of Kiwis are still in the default fund that they went into by default when they first joined KiwiSaver and haven't made an active decision about where they want their KiwiSaver funds.
Can you just break it down really simply for us, how KiwiSaver funds actually work in terms of the gains they receive and the fees that us KiwiSaver users have to pay?
Okay, so with your KiwiSaver account, there's a number of sources of funds that go into it. First of all, there's whatever contributions you yourself are making. If you're employed, then your employer will be putting in 3%. And depending on how much you put in, the government will be putting in up to $500 a year. Then on top of that, your funds are invested and they're earning income. So you have investment returns on top of that. And that will vary according to what type of funds you're in and exactly where your funds are being invested and how it's being managed. So that's all the positive stuff. Then there are about five different fees. So there's management fees, there's trustee fees, there's transaction fees. And those, depending on the type of funds, transaction fees, for example, can be more or less, depending on the number of transactions you're doing. So that obviously all comes off.
Right. They can be pretty significant, can't they?
Oh, absolutely, they can be significant. But it is also worth noting that they are being charged because somebody is providing a service and they're doing something for that money.
Okay. How much of a difference can switching funds make?
If you have a look at, I think it's the Canstar website, they talk about fees making a difference of $14,000 to $65,000. So there's sort of $50,000 difference depending on what type of fund you're in. So it can make a substantial difference. And we're talking over the lifetime of the fund, but certainly it can make a difference.
And what does this new tracking tool for the KiwiSaver fees actually help people discover?
Well, what it can help you to do is actually understand how much you are paying in fees in proportional terms, but also compare your fund to other funds so you can see relatively how well you're doing. But more importantly, it also looks at your fees relative to your returns. In some cases, it might be worthwhile while paying higher fees because you may actually be getting a better return from that fund. But generally, it's difficult to justify that over the longer term.
All right, Claire, give us your advice to anyone with a KiwiSaver fund this morning who wants to get the very best out of their investments.
Okay, well, I can't possibly give you any advice, but I would suggest that they either get advice, but there tends to be a reluctance to do that. So have a look at the Sorted website is what I would really recommend. The Sorted and the FMA's new KiwiSaver tracker. Have a look at these things, educate yourself, and also read your statements and understand your KiwiSaver account.
Awesome work. Thanks so much, Claire. Really appreciate your time. That's Claire Matthews from Massey University.